magla-live react tayo dito sa Sit Down with the Broadcast Media interview ni President Bongbong Marcos. Ayan.
Mr. President, you talked about the ease of doing business. You talk about power rates, which is one of the highest in Asia.
Not anymore.
True.
Not anymore.
No, talaga,
Europe is the same now as us.
But what are your plans during your administration to bring this down together with the private sector? Because that is one of the issues that is being raised by many investors around the world.
Before, medyo number two na lang ngayon. Dati number one talaga.
Kasi hindi lang itong administration na ito. Even the past administrations have always been promising.
Yeah.
Let's improve the ease of doing business. So, the bureaucracy.
The bureaucracy has to be streamlined. The ease of doing business is because we're talking about trade. So the digitalization is going to be a very important part of that. We have to digitalize customs. We have to digitalize all of these collecting agencies so that the BIR, even the central bank, the payments can be made over the internet. All of those things that we don't do now. We have to remove then any the discretion. It's just
like, correct.
If the thing is to
tama. Sorry.
Kahit wala kang kausap na tao, nagagawa mo yung kailangan mo. Kung makuha mo yung lisensya mo, makuha mo yung permit mo, makapagbayad ka nung whatever it is, ng fee, whatever it is to get your papers, whatever it is. So we came up against a very disturbing finding here in the Philippines. The ordinary Filipinos who have connectivity talk to every aspect of their lives through the internet, to the school of the children, to their business, to their friends.
Totoo yan.
The only entity that they do not talk to over the internet is the government, because the government is not digitalized. So
totoo.
Let's digitalize totoo. The government, and we will go, that will take us a long way to helping in the ease of doing business.
Sorry, I just have to cut there. Totoo ho yung sinasabi ni PBBM na yan. Halos lahat ho ng, like ako personally, lalo ako very connected to the internet. And my life depends on the internet. Lahat ng aspeto ng buhay ko ngayon nakadepende sa internet. Yung school ng mga anak namin is online. My law school is online. Business ng wife ko is online, etc., etc. Lahat ng transaksyon namin online, GCash, cash transfer, etc., etc. Everything is online except government. Nagpa-renew ako ng lisensya recently. Diyos ko, hindi ko makakuha ng appointment sa LTO. Appointment nila. Weeks pa in the future. Sabi nga ni PBBM kanina, transparency, accountability, issue talaga yan. Pero hindi yan ang sinasabi ng mga negosyante. Ang sinasabi ng mga negosyante, ease of doing business, cost of energy, tsaka legislative assurance. Diba? Grabe talaga. Ang hirap umano. Ang hirap gumalaw sa Pilipinas, lalo pa magsa-start ka ng negosyo. Feeling ko ang pinakamadali lang na mag-start ng negosyo sa Pilipinas, MSMEs, micro, small, and medium enterprises. Kasi DTI lang yun. Hindi mo kailangan ng SEC. And napakadali sa DTI. I think, yun yung pinakamadali for now. You pay everything online. Tapos mag-a-apply ka online. You don't need to go to the office. Yung iba, BPLO. Di ba? Pupunta ka sa BPLO, Business Permit Licensing Office, sa mga LGUs. Isa pa yan, LGU, hindi digitized. Just go, what? Kagigil. Bago ka makakuha ng permit mo, talaga, isang araw na inubos mo. So, totoo yan. Totoo itong sinasabi ng PBBM na to. Gobyerno lang ang hindi, digitalized. And referring now, transition tayo, no, dun sa hinihingi ni Kuya na transparency and accountability. Kapag tinanggal mo yung mga discretionary processes, okay, pag tinanggal mo yung discretionary processes, yung mga parte ng proseso na may mga taong magdidesisyon kung mag-move forward ka o hindi. Pag tinanggal mo yun at in-automate mo yun, ginawa mong digital, napakadaling mag pagtayo ng negosyo sa Pilipinas. Napakadali talaga. Ang tuloy natin.
The problem of energy is a very major one. It's a very major one because at the bottom of it is simple. The supply of power the demand for power far exceeds the supply that we are producing. And there's also a problem in distribution, which is why the prices are so high.
NGCP, Meralco.
But in the long term, once we fix what we can at home, in the long term, and that is one of the things that we will talk about a great deal on these trips, is bringing new power plants into the Philippines. And of course, we are stressing on renewables because we're trying to improve the mix of power generation between traditional and renewables. So that is, but that's a long term. Anything I start, anything this government starts, we will not see the end. Ang nuclear power plant, 6 years, 7 years. Ang floating wind turbine, 6 years, 7 years, ganun din. Anything is 6 years, 7 years. But we have to start. So that's what we
start planning. Somewhere. We right, start. Right.
Isang tanong na lang, baka kasi hindi na ako makakatanong eh. Mr. President, ang ating utang, 13.6 trillion pesos, ang taas-taas. And our debt-to-service ratio is more than 60%. Paano natin po ipababa ito?
That's growth. We will pull ourselves out of debt.
Namatay yung mic.
That really is the
guiding principle to the economic plan.
And through investments and the pledges that you will be focusing on.
Well, yes, make them real so yeah. that growth continues to pull us out and then provide new jobs. Now we have to, we're very proud that we're at 4.2% unemployment rate, which is like, you know, you cannot have a recession if your employment rate's that low. But despite that, Tama. We still have to make the jobs the jobs more higher quality. We have to make them better.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So agree. These green jobs, which is what we're talking about, and even the new technologies that are going to be used for our OFWs, all of these things, the upskilling, the reskilling, that's all we talk about. That's all because those are the things that we need to do. It's not one simple thing. There is no silver bullet. We have to do very many things to make it right. Because what we are in fact doing is restructuring the entire Philippine economy to adjust to the new world global economy.
Who is Sas?
President Sas of SMNI News Channel. My first question is related to privatization. Earlier this month, Department of Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista
Naiya.
Revealed that you have plans to privatize the operations of NAIA. And as we all know, privatizing government assets has been a very contentious issue in our country. For example, the predecessor of your father, former President Corazon Aquino, you know, has been lambasted for privatizing a lot of government assets.
We have no plans to privatize anything. Okay. There's no plan to privatize anything. Rather we do the opposite. No, when Secretary J.B. Bautista was talking about that, I think we may have been, maybe he misspoke or he was misinterpreted, but you cannot privatize an airport to begin with. They cannot own the airport. No, a private firm cannot own the
airport. Operations lang.
At best, kasi na nga nagkakagulo, nagkakaproblema tayo dito sa airport. At again, in New York, meron kaming nakilala, the group that runs Gatwick Airport, they run London Airport, they run several big airports, that we're asking them, what can they do? Can they come in and help us so that we can increase the traffic through the Manila Airport? And they said they could. And so they're coming, they were here last week and to look at the operations of the airport, and especially since we had that problem in New Year's Day and this recent outage with the UPS. So at most we will have a management contract. Come in and manage
operations lang.
And they say that they, without changing anything, without changing, without new equipment, without building a new runway, that they can increase the traffic from what is presently, they refer to as 35 movements per hour to up to 45 movements per hour without changing anything. So we want that. And those skills can only be had from this group. And well, no, there are several groups, but they can be had from the private sector group who have huge experience in running ports and running airports.
This is a good development, especially ngayon kay PBBM. Kasi, and this is an honest observation, he has been very out of touch. Ibig sabihin, lahat tayo, clueless. Hindi natin alam kung ano ba talagang iniisip ng presidente sa napakaraming issues. And mukhang ano, it seems, for the simula nung umupo siya up until this moment, up until today, parang ano siya, naka-cordon sanitaire na parang hindi mo malapitan, hindi mo alam ang di ka makakuha ng impormasyon, etc., etc. So at least, this is a good, ano, this is a good development. Sana kahit once a month may ganito. Sana kahit once a month lang. Hindi naman kailangan araw-araw, di ba? Kasi mahirap naman kay PBBM yung araw-araw ganito. Pero at least siguro kahit once a month, mayroong ganitong klase ng ano si Presidential Communications Office. Okay, so kung kayo po ay nasa US, UK, Canada, Italy, France, Spain, at Ireland, gamitin nyo na po ang SendWave sa inyong pong mga remittance needs. Dahil kapag nagpadala po kayo through SendWave, wala po yung fees. Wala po yung remittance fees, mga kodjero. Kaya yun, no? Gagawin nyo lang, i-download nyo lang ang SendWave app sa Apple App Store at sa Google Play. At irehistro nyo ang inyong account details at pwedeng-pwede na kayo magpadala sa inyong mga minamahal sa buhay sa pamamagitan ng GCash, pawn shop, cash pickup sa iba't ibang pawn shops at iba't ibang mga bangko sa Pilipinas. At kung gagamitin nyo po nga yung promo code na Coach Jared, ay makakakuha pa kayo ng inyong ng $10 free credit sa inyong unang padala. So huwag niyo pong kalimutan gamitin ang SendWave. Once again, kung kayo po ay nasa US, UK, Canada, Italy, France, Spain, Ireland, and Belgium.